Oh, come on. You gonna change your shirt right when we're starting?
Episode 31 of the Side Project Podcast. Are we doing it now? Are we bringing the fist bump?
that's what we're doing.
Fist bumps back, man.
Who's the pitcher? Who's the catcher?
What's up, everybody? For those that don't know, my name is Chazzy, a.k.a. Big Daddy Warbucks.
I always think that's going another direction, as many episodes as I've done.
Yeah, there's some things I want to say, but we can't say it, man. We can't say it. YouTube frowns upon it, man. This is Captain Juicebox. Can you sip it in one take?
Hey. Don't forget the underscore, man. I don't know why you look back when I said underscore.
No, because I thought I saw something in the reflection there. But as you guys can see, obviously, we're trying a different setup. How do you guys like the different setup? I know that it changes the things with the pictures in the background and whatnot, but I think it looks kind of good. You guys let us know if you like it, then we'll keep it going, right? You know what I mean? We'll keep it going, moving forward. When this comes out, everybody will have already seen it, but IGN is doing their summer games of 2020.
I don't know
how long it is. You know, the live thing in place of E3.
Yeah.
So there's all kinds of different news coming out today.
It's our virtual E3.
Yeah. Basically, it's kind of like a virtual E3 situation. And we're not talking about it today because it's happening right now as we're shooting. So I don't know. You guys may see us straight to the point about it. We might just throw some stuff up on Instagram and converse with you guys about it. Or maybe we'll talk about it next week.
Yeah, because I've been loving the interaction we've been getting a lot lately.
Yeah, man.
When you do the not a simple post, but when you do just like a post, like a certain subject will come up, right? Boom. Yeah. What do you guys think about the remake? Such movie, right?
Thank you, guys. Thank you guys so much for interacting.
It's actually been really dope.
We'd love to converse with you guys and get ideas other than us too, you know?
All the voting went against us.
Oh my God.
As far as the Ace Ventura remake.
Everybody was actually for the Ace Ventura remake when we were actually against it. But hey,
everybody has
their own opinions. You know what I mean?
I don't see anybody doing that kind of comedy.
Jim Carrey?
And I think it's kind of past that time, like I said.
Bumblebee Tuna!
I think we're kind of past that point.
What was the other one that we did? Oh, there was a lot of people that were not interested.
In the Snyder Cut.
And the PS5 reveal. Both of them.
Well, because I think it was Dadskin Game. Shout out to you.
Yeah.
I was going back and forth. I'm trying to interact with people.
Yeah, I saw that.
He was saying
bad
that
taste
it's kind of like
mouth, right?
yeah because I think it went a little bit past this point, like come on dude, like, and then we were actually talking and I was trying to be funny, but like Sony for real and Xbox for real, like
you guys should say,
Xbox
I mean,
was already sending out testers right to like certain people
Dad King was talking about that with
obviously
us,
they like big accounts you know,
I mean come on, but you guys, we're like 31 episodes in, I mean I think it's about time you send us some betas, you know,
but PS5 hasn't done anything, they haven't released anything, so it's kind of like at this point it's like all right, well we'll just wait they keep pushing everything back.
Yeah, I think it's upsetting gamers. You know what I mean? They just come on, let's get to it. As of this recording, as of us right now, today, not when this comes out.
On this day, when the wind is blowing.
Exactly. Tomorrow for us in real time right now will be the PS5 reveal. But by the time this comes out, it'll have already happened over the weekend.
Yeah.
So we'll touch on it further.
It'll be good though. I think it'll give people a chance to kind of like really process it and break it down. See how they feel.
I mean,
of course,
we'll probably do a straight to the point, or we'll probably just throw some stuff up and converse with some people, get some ideas.
Maybe a little IG story or something.
Yeah, we'll do something, and then we'll touch on it probably a little bit more in depth next week's podcast, maybe. But one of the things that came out, I think it started today. Actually, I posted something on the Side Project page. Nintendo's Summer Game Sale. They're doing all these summer games. It's kind of self-explanatory. Nintendo Summer Games. What does that mean? It means it's right in the title.
Deals on a bunch of games. Up to 50% off on certain titles.
Is what they're saying. Save up to 50% on select digital games for the Nintendo Switch system. Summer Game Sale starts today, 9 a.m., which already happened.
6-9, yeah.
Yeah, to the 16th at 11 midnight, basically. Yeah. You know what I mean? But I wanted to since Jar of Retro, everybody knows Jar of Retro. If you watch the podcast, we talk about him all the time. Yeah. We converse with him. He's been on the show. He's called in on the show like twice, I think now. Yeah. And we're gonna do it again here today. Let's see if we got him on the line still. Hey, Mike, you there?
Yo, 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 what up, what up?
There he yes, is. There he Ladies is. And gentlemen, it is Mike from Jar of Retro on Instagram. That is J, that I'm not going to spell out Jar. Yeah. You guys know how to spell Jar. That's Jar underscore of retro. Underscore retro on Instagram. And if you don't know, I'm going to tell you real quick. He's a big raffler. He's a big giveaway-er, I guess.
Yeah.
giveaway-er. Totally. We're just creating names here today. You know what I mean? He's a big raffler, a big giveaway-er. He does a lot of stuff.
Shout out to him because of him, I mm-hmm. picked up that real good expansion pack, you know, had a little box protector for it and everything. Everything yeah. was
well. He's shape. On the line, so and you can tell him.
You know, yeah, yeah. No, that's what I'm
Shout
saying.
Shout out to Mike. I don't know where he's at. I don't know if he's here or not. Mike's like, no, I'm right here. Hello, hello.
Dre's blown Yo. In the wind somewhere. You know, yeah. Thanks to you, man. I was able to play Donkey Kong 64 again. Yeah. You know, I had my 64.
Yeah, man. I was really happy to get excited, that, dude, man.
Yeah, I appreciate it, man. So yeah,
yeah, so we got Mike on the line. We want to talk with you guys about these the summer game sales for Nintendo. We want to talk to Mike about it because, like I said, he does a lot of giveaways and a lot of raffles that are centered, not always, but they are
majority
Nintendo centric. You know yeah. what I mean? You do a lot of Nintendo stuff, right, Mike?
Yeah, 100%, man. That's probably the main portion of my collection.
Yeah, definitely. And if you guys, again, if you don't, go to Jar of Retro on Instagram. And if you're not following him already, check him out, follow him, look at all his stuff. It's fucking amazing. You guys need to get involved. Do it right now. Hold on. Hold on. We're going to give him a second. Ready? One. Two. There you go. You should have already done it. You should have pressed follow.
I was like, wait, what?
There you
What's
go.
Going on, dude?
Just like
hey,
when
I
you
just got 10 followers.
Oh, shit. Oh, man. Shit. You see what we're doing? Sponsorships. Sponsorships. So, yeah, Mike, I wanted to talk to you, man. We wanted to, like, we talked about it off camera and in our own times several times. I mean, I think we may have touched on, I know we touched on a lot of Smash Bros. Stuff with you before. I don't know. Yeah. I think we may have mentioned like how Nintendo.
Your favorite game too, right? Fire Emblem?
No. Yeah. I don't. You know what? I'm not going to bash on Fire Emblem because I've never truly sat down and played it, but it just annoyed me. Like, we're not going to get into it, but it just annoyed me that there were so many characters going into Smash Bros. Like, can we have another franchise? Yeah. Although Fire Emblem yeah. does have some good music though.
Yeah.
I will
yeah.
say that. But yeah, so like we've talked about Nintendo's again, like I said, off camera or on camera, they're how would you say it? I guess their inability to run true deals when you compare it to other gaming yeah. companies like Sony, Microsoft, or what, you know, Steam does on PC, or even the Epic Game Store giving yeah, away GTA it, yeah. for free, Subnautica, and Super Meat Boy, and a plethora of That's fucking games.
Plethora.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But
totally.
Like, for instance, Mike is on the phone, you guys. He's not here, and we're not doing a FaceTime thing. Sorry. He is on the line, though. He's on the phone. So he may not be looking at the what we're looking at, and we'll probably throw some stuff up on screen for you guys to see. But I'm looking at currently, Mike, like all the deals that they have on the eShop right now, on the game store for Nintendo. Like, for instance, Super Mario Party, that came out a decent time ago, and it's still...
That's not 50%, though.
No, it's not. And it's $41.99. For Super Mario Party.
So 42 out of 59.
Yeah.
So.
You got to add in the tax. You're looking at probably like what, 40, 45, 46?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right?
You're essentially right. buying the game brand new.
Yeah. You know yeah. what I mean? I mean, $60 is what it goes for. And like, also, I'm sorry, Mike, that we haven't really let you talk too much here. I know we got you on
the phone.
And you're not saying anything. I just want to set this up.
Shut it,
I know. They're like, come on, damn it, Chaz. Let somebody else speak. But like Nintendo has a thing where they still sell all their games, the majority. I don't want to say all, but it is, you know, for lack of better words, a lot of games. They still sell them at $60, even if they're like one, old two, three, fuck, four, yeah. 5 years old. They still sell them. Like, for instance, Super yeah. Mario Bros. U Deluxe, that's a port from Wii U. And
they're
years
still,
ago, that game came out.
Half off.
Years ago. And they still sold it for $60. Right now on the game store, it's running at $41.99. I mean, what do you think about that, Mike? It's a port from Wii U at $60. And then during the sale, it's only $41.99.
Yeah, I just think, especially because it's a port, they should have a way better deal. Or just the before it's even a deal, the normal price should just be what it is on sale right now for $41.99.
Yeah,
you know,
and then have
yeah.
a sale on top of that, so get it for like $20 or something.
Yeah, definitely. Hey, hold on one sec, you guys. For those that are watching and or listening, my brother Zane, our brother, me and Mike's brother, he's sitting off to the side, and I forgot to ask you, dude, do you want headphones so you can hear what Mike is saying? There's headphones right there behind you. go ahead, just open that and grab those green ones.
And for those who can't see, he has some mighty fine looking kneecaps.
He's got super short shorts on, and just plug it in. You know, you
tell, like real, tell them. It was real like 70s, 80s yeah. style short shorts.
Yeah, I'm grab actually those. Looking at the deals right now.
You're looking at the deals? Awesome.
So you're probably looking at the same thing that we're looking at.
Yeah, awesome. Sorry about that, guys. I know. As you know, if you watch the solo pod, super professional. Change the camera during the show. We change audio during the show. We add headphones for people during the show. That's just how we go. Can you hear?
You know what? We should just change it to the improv side project.
I know. Side project. The improv show. All right. So you're looking at it. Let's see. What other games on here came out a long time ago?
Donkey Kong Country,
Toad, Treasure Tracker. Correct me if I'm wrong. Did Captain Toad originally release on Wii U, or am I tripping?
Yes, it did.
It did, right?
Yeah, it's a port. Okay,
so that's another port. And I give them a little bit more props on this one. They're selling that for $40.
Deal is $27.99.
Yeah, with the deal is $27.99. That's a little bit better, wouldn't you agree?
Yeah.
You agree?
Yeah, I definitely agree, and that's how they should be setting the bar with
exactly,
the price.
Exactly, exactly, dude. Like Donkey Kong Country Tropical Freeze is $60 still, and it's on sale for $41.99. You know what, I find that absolutely ridiculous.
You know what I think?
It is a really good game, but still, I mean, the amount of time it's been out, it's not an A-list Breath of the Wild kind of game, you know?
Yeah, exactly, dude. Exactly.
That's what I was actually going to get to. I think that certain ones, just because of their title or how long that franchise has been around, they're going to try to charge more for those.
Yeah, you know? Well, I mean, like I said a few minutes ago, like Nintendo, they always do this. Like they don't drop their prices. Yeah. Like you know what you're getting when you get a Nintendo
console.
It's kind of like
that fucking sell. Like, oh, it's gonna be $60. We're gonna give you like $1 off.
Yeah, you know what I mean.
Like, totally buy it.
Like, here's another one. This goes. I don't know if this is Nintendo's fault or if this is Bethesda's fault because they do this with every Skyrim game. But Skyrim is how many years old? You guys.
Yeah. Skyrim. Elder
Scroll. Zane. Again, I know he's off camera, you guys, but Zane, I mean, you originally got me into Skyrim like 7-8 years ago when you got it for the 360, I think, right? Yeah, he's saying, yeah, if you guys can't hear him. And it's still...
Yes.
Yes, there you go. It's still $60, dude, for the Nintendo Switch. But I do give them that's disappointing as hell. I mean, a game that old selling on a Nintendo Switch console, so the graphics are already down significantly when you can play Skyrim on PC, like the definitive edition, the upgraded edition, whatever it's called.
Same thing's going to happen with like a GTA on PS5, PS4, et cetera.
Yeah.
Like,
sell them for a little bit cheaper, I think. I mean, look at PC's giving away GTA 5 for free.
Let me ask you this, Mike. And I think we've talked about this before. I'm more of a physical guy. I like to have physical copies of my games.
He likes to lay down in bed and actually touch you and coddle you and cuddle you.
I want to feel the corners of those.
He likes
boxes,
to breathe on
your
neck. He goes like this, you guys. ASMR community is going to love this. Juice goes, hey, juice box. Like that. He does that all the time.
That comes with the mega dick addiction, you know?
Oh, it does. Son of a bitch. Does. It really does. I mean, you can ask Mike. Like Mike, right here. I'm going to act like Juice, and you tell me if this turns you on right here. You ready?
Yeah.
Sip my juice. I mean, did that titillate you?
Totally.
Yeah, see what I'm saying, Juice? I'm going to pound it.
I'm not pounding any of that.
Go ahead. Keep going the way you're saying.
But like I was saying, I like to have more physical copies, right? Obviously, you being a collector yourself, you would want to have a physical copy of something, whether it's limited edition, whether it's just a game you just enjoyed, where, you know, like Fire Emblem or something like that. That was just nothing crazy to rave about, right?
Yeah.
My problem here is that this is on the eStore, so this is only obviously digital downloads and stuff, right?
Yeah, I don't know, and I don't
think... I'm paying that price for something that I can't even like physically hold. And that's my issue.
I don't know for certain because I didn't look at it. I didn't know you were going to ask that or talk about that. I don't think, though, they're running any of these deals on physicals. I'm not sure.
Yeah, I was curious about that, too, as well, Julio, because I would prefer to be paying those kind of prices than getting a physical for sure as a collector. Yeah,
I agree as well. Yeah. Not that anybody asked me, but I just want to let you guys know.
Yeah, well, because, you know, it's about Mike, man. But yeah, see, because even then, though, maybe even for digital copies, it should be a little cheaper, maybe $5 off or something like that on top of whatever they're doing. Just because,
I mean, that's actually a really good point. I never even thought about that.
And that's something maybe you guys could chime in on. Like a lot of the video game collectors, a lot of the people who just like to collect in general and stuff like that.
Hex, retro Mega.
Yeah, Hex, dude, I'm wearing a shirt.
Oh, which is wearing
again.
A shirt today.
How do you guys feel about that? I'm not being able to have a physical copy at that sale price. Yes. So why should I have to suffer because like I like physical stuff versus
stuff virtual? I agree with you. I agree with you. Also, I don't think I finished it. Skyrim is $60, you guys, on the Nintendo Switch right now. But I do give
that
them
that truly is half off though. $30.
Yeah, it's $30 on sale right now, and I give them props for that. But I do think that they only did that because Skyrim is so old, because their actual Nintendo games are not
that cheap.
That cheap. In comparison, another one is also Wolfenstein, $60, $30 on sale.
Isn't that like an OG PC game?
The original Wolfenstein is an old school game. Yeah, but this one, New Colossus, it's $60 right now, $30 on sale. The Witcher is also $60, and that is a port that has been downgraded because of the Nintendo Switch's graphical capabilities are lacking compared to PC and other consoles.
Yeah.
So it's downgraded The Witcher 3, which is an amazing game, by the way. I have it on PC.
And that's not even a full $30.
No, it's $60 starting and then $41.99 once again. Did you ever get around to The Witcher, Mike?
No, I never got to play Witcher.
You
got to
check it out. It's one of those games that kind of takes over your life, though. Like, it's an in-depth game. You know what I mean? Like Skyrim, like WoW, stuff like that.
Yeah, I'm very tempted. I've heard so much good stuff, like, to this day, Witcher 3 especially.
Yeah, in my opinion, not to down Nintendo, but I would... I know you don't have a PC, but you do have an Xbox. I would personally get The Witcher on Xbox. I would not get it on Nintendo.
Oh, for sure. I'll look into it then.
You know, and then you got games like this one. I agree with a little bit more, but it also may be because it's one, it's not a Nintendo game, and then two, because sequel is going to be has been announced and is upon us soon.
Not only that though, you got to think like same thing like with The Witcher, right? The compatibility of the graphics and everything they're actually going to be able to play.
Yeah, Blizzard games. Overwatch is a little bit more because it's kind of a cartoony style, so it does fit the Switch, and I'm glad that they're not charging $60 for it. They're charging $40 for it, and it's currently on sale for $20 right now, which is great.
Wow. So that's actually not bad.
Yeah, that is a deal. For anybody that wants to play Overwatch and decides to take advantage of it on the Switch and take advantage of the eShop deals right now, it's $20 on the eShop. Go and get that. It's also the Legendary Edition, which is on sale.
Maxed out, so you'd have all the maps or whatever it comes with.
I mean, Mike, again, Diablo, that's an old game. It's a port. Yeah, it's a PC game ported to Nintendo. $60 starting the Eternal Collection and $30 on sale. I mean, it's better. At least it's $30, but I think it should be $30 starting.
Always be.
Yes.
I have a list that I made of these games that are prices that I think that they're great prices, but they should always be these prices. You know, they
should
be.
Yeah.
Especially if they're ports, like even that Star Wars Jedi game, right?
Yeah. Which one? Where's it at? This one right here.
Jedi Knight 2.
That's a lot better. That's an old school game, I believe. Yeah. Like,
and that's
really
actually
old.
Pretty good.
That's not bad. $7.49 on sale right now. Yeah, $7.50. One that if you see right here, the Mario and Rabbids. Mm. We were talking about this earlier this morning, Mike. Mario and Rabbids Kingdom Battle is $60, which I get it. It's a Nintendo game, but it's on sale right now for
really
$14.99. That's a fucking deal. That's how you do a deal, Nintendo.
Yeah, that's incredible for a Mario game.
Yes.
You know, even though it's like an offside game.
Yeah. I think, do you think, Mike, that, because I've seen a lot of mixed reviews on the Mario Rabbids game, a lot of mixed reviews. Do you think that they're selling it at $15 right now because of the mixed reviews?
I would say so. I watched some gameplay on YouTube just to see if I was interested in buying it. Honestly, I wasn't too intrigued with what I saw.
I feel the same way, yeah.
The graphics look phenomenal, but the style of gameplay just kind of, it was just boring to watch.
It's like that strategy, like one hit, then the other person hits, and then one hit, you know, like an RPG strategy type situation.
It's just like a turn-based kind of thing.
What was that, Mike? Sorry.
It's like a turn-based kind of RPG.
Turn-based, there we go. That's what I was trying to say. Yeah, yeah, you nailed it.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Just like in comparison to Super Mario Party, Mario Bros. U Deluxe, Mario Tennis Aces, those are all $60 starting, only $41.99 on sale. And then you got Mario Rabbids, which is $60, $14.99 on sale. That's a big deal, and I do think it's a contribution to due to the fact of the mixed reviews, you know?
Yeah.
Totally.
Go ahead.
No, I was just going to say, and I think... that game is like more directed for kids. I think it's just more for kids, and that's all.
Yeah, I agree a little bit. And then you got all these. I mean, you go down a little bit more, and you got like these Team 17 publisher sales, which are I believe those are like third party developers and stuff, you know, not big AAA games or anything. Like Yooka-Laylee is on sale right now for $13.59. That's cool. I've seen decent reviews on that. And you got like Worms and all these other Overcooked special editions and stuff that do very well overseas. Those are all really, really cheap. $6.79, $10.19. I'm just throwing random numbers out at you guys. You know, The Room is on sale for like $2.49, like Juice just said. So I mean, if you're looking for like third party games and stuff like that, you're set for like major prices. And then Bandai Namco has their sales right now, like Dragon Ball FighterZ.
That's actually pretty good considering. Yeah. So it starts at 60 and it's $14.99.
Which you got that on Xbox, right?
No, I got the Kakarot.
Oh, okay.
Kakarot
and you got that edition. From Mike,
yeah, again. Yeah,
another one. Yeah.
Another game, yep. Yes, sir. Yeah.
Little Nightmares is a great game, you guys. I have that. I think I actually have it for Switch. I think I got it for Switch. I think I got it on my PC, and then I don't know, something happened, and then I ended up getting it for my Switch.
No, you regardless, definitely got it on your matter. Switch because you tried to show me how to play
yeah,
it.
Yeah, yeah, you're right. When we were going to play a Smash or Mario Kart or something, yeah. And I was playing it. So right now, Little Nightmares, the complete edition is $30 on sale for $10 right now. So I mean, you do have some good deals, but like the Nintendo AAA games or whatever, they don't really run deals on it. And to call this a summer game sale and
not be true to that.
Not be like, 50%. It's not really, there's not too many in my personal opinion that I'm like, oh shit, Nintendo's running a summer game sale. I'm getting this, I'm getting that, I'm getting this. Because yeah. It's not really any sales.
No, yeah. but then I mean, then you look at games also like Doom, though. I mean, that's a fresh game, though. I could understand why. Oh, that's
but
not
the
even
graphical
Doom. That's
capabilities.
Not even, that's not even Doom Eternal, right?
No, it's the
right?
first. That's what I'm saying.
That's
the first
Doom.
Doom is still $60 on sale for $30. The second Doom already came out.
Yeah.
No, so that should be significantly less.
That should probably be like 50.
I was happy
bucks.
To see Kirby.
Yeah, no, Kirby is Kirby Star Allies, right?
Yeah, they had a good price for that. It was on sale like 2 years ago for $25, and I think it's what, $17 now.
No, it's $41.99
again. $41, dude.
Oh, are you joking me?
Yeah.
Oh my,
$60 and then $41.99 on sale.
That did not titillate Mike in the slightest.
Yeah. You see what I'm saying? It's disappointing because I really want that Kirby game too, but some of these games I can't bring myself to spend $60 when like the majority of them are ports that I already played, possibly beat, or maybe didn't get to beat, you know, got rid of my Wii U or whatever the case may be, and I want to play them again. Like for instance, Super Mario Bros. U Deluxe. I know it's got mixed reviews. A lot of people dislike those games,
but still,
I personally like them. I enjoy them and I want to play them with my boys.
I mean, if you have like a lack of taste in video games, like I get it, you know?
And I want to play them and I want to enjoy them, but I can't bring myself to pay $60 for it, and I still kind of don't justify the $41.99 price.
Yeah,
and not at all.
And again, like I was telling Mike, dude, like that. My biggest problem with this is that these are for the most part, I should have looked more. Is that they're digital downloads, dude. If
yeah,
I have a physical copy,
I want the
of this,
copies, man.
Maybe I could see myself stretching and saying, okay, maybe because it's a physical copy, there's a resale value, there's something, or even just for you know for shits and gigs to keep it for memories and stuff like that.
Yeah, definitely.
Especially if it was something like Doom, right? So I wouldn't mind the Doom if it was at least physical, because then I could say, look, I got it for Nintendo, then I got it for Xbox, and then these are physical copies that I have, right?
Yeah.
And it's just I just not for digital downloads.
No. So. I think Nintendo needs to cater to their fan base a little bit more with several different things. But since we're just talking about prices today, I think they should run a little bit more deals. Since Nintendo always keeps their prices at top notch, at least maybe once a fucking year, drop those motherfuckers down more than $5 to $10. Come on. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
When you've got other companies giving things away for free.
No, especially considering the fact that if you got new game releases that are coming out, or if you got new editions of certain games, like you're further into the series, like
yeah,
I know I
like
keep
Doom.
Saying Doom, right?
Yeah.
So like
no, it's
there's
a perfect
Doom,
example.
And then there's Doom Eternals. Like,
yes.
Why am I paying half price when like you know? It just
why am I paying
sense.
$60 for Skyrim that's been on every damn console and every generation?
And I have to keep repaying for it.
And I have to keep repaying for it every single time. And since it's on the Switch, its graphical capabilities have been downgraded like a motherfucker. Why am I still paying $60? What are you guys doing? Both Nintendo and Bethesda. What are you guys doing? So, I mean, just to round this out, Mike, we'll let you go. I know you got other things to do. What do you want from Nintendo as far as, like, prices? Where's your dream? Whether it's, you know, them just dropping them normally for people after it's been a couple years, or if it's them running something like a one-year game sale,
Mega
like
sale.
I said, yeah. Where are you at on your prices? What do you think is good deals?
For me to justify a digital download, it should honestly be $15 or cheaper, and I know that's a pretty low number for higher listed games, but that's just what my opinion. If it's digital, I justify it more, like I said, if it's $15 or lower. And I think even if it's an A-list game, after 2 years, it should go down to $40 or, you know, maybe three. like forever, you know, like 60, yeah. like on the $60, even if it's the greatest game like Breath of the Wild, mm-hmm. it's still hard to pull the trigger, you know, 3 years later, 4 years yeah. later. Or whatever.
I think right now, since you mentioned Breath of the Wild, it's been three years. I think Breath of the Wild should be $49.99 at the most.
Yes, I agree completely.
You know what I mean? $49.99 at the most. If you don't want to drop yep. it half, I understand, because unfortunately I do believe Nintendo is a little bit greedy, mm-hmm. but at least $49.99, at least give me $10 off for a game that's been 3 years old.
Yeah, dude, yeah. please. Yeah. yeah.
So, all right, Mike, we're going to let you go, man. You guys, if you are not, be sure to go to Instagram and follow Jar of Retro. That's Jar_of_Retro on Instagram. He does all kinds of amazing raffles, all kinds of amazing giveaways when the time calls for it. And yeah. as right now, hopefully when this episode comes out, you're still doing a bunch, but you guys need to take advantage of it and hop on it right now, because Mike is on a goddamn raffle train right now. Yeah. I mean, he is just giving away doing raffles on all kinds of stuff. Just choo-choo! All aboard!
It's just hockey of raffles.
Yes, dude, it's just all in your face. It's a raffle here, it's a raffle there. He's taking a page out of Juice's book, and he's just got juice for everybody. Anything you want to say while we sayonara you, Mike?
I don't know if it's for everybody.
Don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment to the Side Project Podcast. And don't forget,
man. I love it.
Do whatever though. You
want to. Oh, damn, he hung up.
Hey, that's kind of like Tony yesterday when we were playing
Call of Duty.
We're
man.
In the middle of Call of Duty, and then our boy was just raging because he kept getting killed. I mean, we were all getting killed. It was yeah, pretty we shitty were start a to a
bad
game.
Bad game. But you know what? We were having a bad game as far as like killing people and doing yeah. good. But man, we were having fun because we went into it going, yeah. man, let's just get into an all-out
yeah.
war.
Yeah, and
like,
we jumped right when everybody jumped. Yeah, so it was actually pretty yeah. fun.
We were playing Plunder, by the way. Plunder yeah. for people that we weren't doing a Battle Royale. Yeah. We were doing Plunder.
He was just raging a little too hard, and we yeah. heard him slam something like, wow,
quit.
Like, I fucking quit.
Yeah,
just
on.
Like that. Just like Mike. And just yeah, boom, and just stopped doing the
bam,
podcast.
He was out. We were having a lot of fun, though. I mean, it does yeah. suck. Sometimes you get frustrated, but we were having fun. We went into it with the mindset of like, let's get right.
Yeah.
Fuck the recons. You know, forget the secures. Forget yeah. that. We're just going to cause mayhem. You know what yeah. I mean? We're not going to follow the rules. We're just going to mess
Which,
around.
By the
cause
way,
mayhem.
I'm very proud of myself. Mm-hmm. Like after you guys all left me all alone by myself, you know, yeah. You know, cause they do stuff like that. They abandon me all the time.
We do.
But you know what though? At least I play this a hell of a lot more than I played Halo with you. So I mean, I'll say
Dude,
that.
I'm
right?
having a lot of fun for a guy that was, again, yeah. I'm speaking for myself, for a guy yeah. that was originally against Call of Duty. And for, I mean, several reasons, but one, yeah. I did briefly work for Activision at one point, and I worked on Call of Duty, and it was draining. Yeah. And if anybody has ever done any,
that's probably why you got a bad taste in your mouth for it, though.
If anybody's initially. Ever done any, what was it called? QA stuff, you know, mm-hmm. quality assurance and everything. If you've ever worked on games or tested games, like actually for a job, it's not the same
yeah.
as hanging out and playing games. That shit is tiring, dude.
Yeah.
So I don't know. Maybe it left a bad taste in my mouth, but I'm having a lot of fun with Warzone. So anybody want to play with us, you know, we'll mess around. I'm personally not the best. I'm still learning. I'm still yeah. having fun. I also get really high and I zone out and have a lot of fun. So anyway.
He likes your chipmunch in your ear, too.
yeah. So Definitely. Since we're talking about Nintendo real quick, we're going to get into something that we like to do. And it's so fucking dope. What is it? It's dope fan art.
I'm sorry. Like that. Our levels just aren't on the same page right
like
now.
That? Bro, yeah, I'm high energy, man. I'm bringing it to you guys. And this yeah. dope fan art, you want to take it away? You want me to get into it?
No, yeah, let's do it. So this one is actually shared by the Nintendo World.
On Instagram?
It's a dope fan art. It's Mario. And then you see, you know, all the little bombs right there. The little
plants.
Oh,
wait. I got to do it. We're going to throw it up right about now. There we go.
Yeah, okay.
There we go.
So we found this via the Nintendo World, but the artist is actually Truth by Nature. We'll tag them all in the Instagram yeah. right here, whatever, mm-hmm. put it up in post. But it's actually
Mario,
pretty
man.
Dope, man. He's diving. There's some mm-hmm. coin action in there. There's some brick busting action in there.
Yeah, oh, man.
There's
if you guys...
A little mystery coin pop, you know,
yeah,
right
dude,
there.
Oh,
it's all kinds of stuff.
I mean, it's beautiful. Obviously, for the people that are on YouTube right now watching,
and I believe he
you
said
can
he,
see it.
I believe he said this one was done... by what is it?
3D render? Said,
yeah, it was like a 3 Photoshop and Blender, I think it was.
Is that what it said? I cropped it. Sorry guys, I cropped the picture that we're currently
actually,
looking at.
Actually, for the listeners that aren't
watching, now's the perfect time for you to head on over to YouTube. It's on our Instagram, and you can click it and you can lean and you can go to and you look at it. It's really dope, you guys. It's from the Super Mario One is kind of what it looks like, a
yeah,
3D rendering of it. Looks great.
So
you see,
this was done in Blender, so whatever, I'm not sure what Blender is, and
Blender
Photoshop.
And Photoshop. Yeah, there you guys Blender go. Now you know. So for the listeners, again, you guys go look at it. It's the Nintendo World, or you can check out Truth by Nature on Instagram.
That is amazing,
or if you're watching us on YouTube right now, you're looking at it. So it's you see Mario jumping. He's jumping over the gap that you know they usually jump over when you play Mario in any World One technically. You see all the Goombas there, the Piranha Plant. You see the bomb mobs.
I love this right here. Is as he's jumping, obviously. So I don't know if he actually meant, like, you know, he hit it and then he jumped.
Definitely.
And then you see some coins coming out of that too, out of the busted bricks.
He busted the bricks, and you see the actual bricks in the air, like being busted and flying over and everything, and you see the coins. I mean, it's perfect. It's perfect, dude. I know that pee probably came in really
jumping
hard.
Right over the flame.
Right
too,
over the flame that the piranha plant is going. Then he's got the beanstalks, the vines, or whatever they're called in Mario. I actually don't know what those are called. That you climb up. You guys know what I'm talking about, right? You climb up and you go up into the sky and whatnot. I mean, it's just a perfect rendition. Yeah. It's a beautiful rendition of Mario. Zane's sitting on the couch. You want to see? That's what we're looking at, man.
Damn,
really good, right?
Yeah,
that's phenomenal.
I really like the water, though. I know it's probably one of the simpler parts of it.
I like the grass
in
the back.
I like the water, the shadowing,
the reflection
of
the Goombas falling into the water. I mean, Truth by Nature, this is absolutely phenomenal.
Yeah.
Like, it really is absolutely phenomenal. You have done a great, great, great job. Nintendo needs to see this. We appreciate your shit so much. Yeah. We really do. I know that came in rough. We appreciate your shit so much. No, but seriously, thank you to the Nintendo World for sharing this. Truth by Nature, your art. Your fan art of Mario.
Well, I'll answer your question.
Hold on, let me get it. It's dope.
I'll answer his question. It's actually pretty rad.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. So
in the caption it says, "How rad is this?"
It's pretty rad.
Pretty rad, man. Pretty rad. So like, hey, we were talking about this ourselves, man. Just me, you, and Roger just having fun and talking, shooting the shit like boys do.
Not like actual physical shit.
We actually were. He was shooting it, and we were catching like a football, and then we were throwing it back. It gets crazy. It's all over your hands. Yeah. AMC Theaters doubts that it could stay in business because of everything going on in the world.
Am I supposed to feel bad about it?
I don't really feel that bad. I mean, I like going to the movies. We were kind of talking about this. Mm. I like going to the movies. I enjoy going to the movies. But over the past few years, my experience has changed a little bit. I don't know. Just a personal thing. Okay. You know what I mean? I gotten a little bit more used to watching movies at home.
All the time, you get real fucking high, right?
We would. We'd get high. Sometimes we would even drink, too.
Yeah,
we get double going on. What do they call that? What do they call it again?
A little DP action.
Crossfaded. That's what they used to call it back in the days. Yeah. We used to have a good time. But also, so AMC Theater says that they doubt that they could stay in business because of everything that's going on in the world right now. Cinemark, however, says that they're going to be reopening and coming back and soon. I don't know where, probably everywhere, maybe different days.
Here's my problem with AMC, because I was actually reading reports on it, and they were saying that they're going bankrupt. It's just not, you know, they can't keep up with
which
everything.
They were having problems beforehand. Let's not just blame it on COVID.
Let me tell you this, though, right? You're a huge company that you've been around fucking ages, dude, for as long as I can remember. You know,
things change, man.
So when your popcorn jumps to like $5 for like a small thing, and then you're telling me you don't have enough money to hold you up. I know, but I'm just giving an example, right?
Yeah.
So like your popcorn's $5, your hot dog's $10, your Pepsi, you know, for whatever Coke, whatever you drink, for a large one, it's like fucking $15.
Yeah.
So like I'm paying like $100 just to go see a $10 movie, right? Uh-huh. And you're telling me you don't have enough money to keep you afloat over 3 months?
Yeah. Come on. You know
three or four
I mean?
Months?
Well, I guess it, yeah, I guess, yeah, right. I guess it would be like 3 or 4 months.
Yeah.
Which also,
January,
I mean, for
February,
those that
March,
don't
April.
Know, I'm sure.
No, everything closed down fucking March. Shit started closing down
March.
Prior to that. But like
but
March
the,
was like
setting everything.
Stay in your house. You're going to die.
Don't go
if
anywhere.
You breathe.
Don't even look outside.
Yeah. So it was that's what I'm saying, though. You don't.
Yeah.
Really?
I don't know. But one of the things I was going to say is I'm sure I feel like it's common knowledge, but maybe there's some people out there that don't know, and I'm not talking shit. I'm not saying anything bad about it.
You started off.
I feel like it's
rough.
Common knowledge, and if you don't know, you need to know. AMC, like movie theaters in general, they make the majority of their money not off of the ticket sales, but the concession sales.
Yeah. And again, regardless of how you feel about it, regardless of I don't mind that the ticket prices went up. I don't care. Like if the movie is actually worth it. If the movie is worth it, like obviously like a lot of the Avenger movies I saw in theaters.
I didn't wait
for that stuff to drop.
Some movies are like you see it in theaters,
you need the surround sound,
you
need the vibrations.
It's not the same at home, you know? Yeah. I wanna feel it vibrating on my cheeks.
I don't know why you want your cheeks vibrating, but nonetheless. My whole thing is that all that, your prices have been going up for years, even prior to this. Your prices have been going up for years.
It's like the Disneyland effect. I call it the Disney effect.
$10 waters, like it's nuts, dude. And you don't have enough money to keep you afloat. between investments,
things
between
change, what, though,
between
too.
The stocks that people own in your company.
I mean,
come on, dude.
I mean, I don't know, man. I mean, I do kind of, I get it in a sense, but I mean, things change. I mean, we're going to a even more so now because of COVID. This just pushed streaming even more. There's going to be people when everything opens back up that are going to go, I want to go to the theater.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
But then there's also those people that are like, whatever, you know, I've already gotten used to streaming, so fuck it.
Well, I mean, you know what? Again, it's the same thing, kind of like the same concept that for some people it's different because for me, like I have some stuff to work out at home, right? Mm-hmm. I have a bench, I have this, I have that.
Mm-hmm.
It's different when you're in a gym. It's different when you're in a different environment. So it's like, it's the
similar
same thing
with movies,
I could stream
right?
I could stream at home, but unless I got this big ass surround sound, Tony Chavez photographer set up with like 10 different monitors and like mirrors in the roof to like catch every fart and everything.
Like
it's
not,
crazy.
I'm not
dude.
Mark Wahlberg. I don't have a movie theater in my house.
If you, do though, like it's just a different experience from
why
going
I chose Mark Wahlberg specifically. I don't know.
Like I could tell you this though, dude, like if I would have seen Avengers and Tony, you know, going, Iron Man at home.
It's
not
the same.
Had
the
same thing, dude.
Yeah.
And not only that, I think it's more so the reactions that we're getting from people. Like even just
in the theater,
environment
they're like, it amps you up even more.
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
Dude.
To an extent. If you guys are like, I've seen some videos where they're like over the top, where you can't even hear what's going on.
Yeah, yeah.
Tone it the fuck down, because I can't rewind this. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I'm not at home.
Okay, I'm just as excited as you are, and I'm totally for all this enthusiasm.
Yeah.
But I'd also like to hear what he's saying. You know what I mean? Speaking of things that are not the same, did you hear about Looney Tunes?
No.
Because this was our, well, I think it was our parents' era, but we still grew up in it, right? Was it our parents' era? Would it be our parents? Looney Tunes?
So what happened with Looney Tunes?
Okay, anyway. Looney Tunes, No More Guns. The HBO Max is rebooting Looney Tunes, the cartoon series, and they decided to disarm characters such as Elmer Fudd and Yosemite Sam.
Yosemite Sam, his whole fucking thing is the little pistols,
man.
Dude. That's his fucking thing, dude.
You can't have them.
Yeah.
The showrunner states, and I quote, they can do cartoony violence, TNT, the Acme stuff, you know, things like that,
but
no more firearms. Okay, so you can blow somebody to pieces, but you can't have a gun.
Again, here's the problem. You're getting people that don't really give a fuck, that are just in it for the money, that are just trying to pump out whatever they can. They're trying to please everybody so they can say, hey, look, guys, we don't have any guns, so you guys can finally watch our shows.
Yeah, I think
dude. Like, it's garbage because you're ruining the cartoon experience for us. I know I'm 30 years old and I still watch cartoons. Yes, I do.
Yeah, fuck yeah, dude.
But nonetheless, dude, like, this is stuff that, like, for nostalgia purposes, I want to look back and tell my grandkids or my nieces and nephews, like, this is what I came up on. They're going to look at people and say, hey, look, we came up watching cartoons that don't have guns in them.
Yeah. Which I mean, but it's not.
Could you
it's not
imagine?
Like, it's not
could
just,
you imagine like a Tom and Jerry without guns, or like without like
without,
a little dynamite?
Yeah,
and
the things that they
like,
do,
yeah,
and
like
little, or like Roadrunner and fuck, what is his name?
Roadrunner.
Not Roadrunner and
the little
and
fucking I forget his name.
Oh my God, what the hell? Roadrunner
and the guy,
his fucking counterpart. Holy shit! I like don't even have it like even remotely. You guys know what I'm talking about, though. Like, imagine them not doing the things that
have to
do, like anvils dropping on them. I just don't understand. Who are the execs that are like, well, I guess it's the showrunner. I have his name somewhere, but I apparently didn't write it down in front of me. But, like, what are the show? I don't understand the logic. Like, you can't have guns, but you can have TNT. You can blow people. You can dismember people. You can do this.
Oh, it's anvils. It's the fucking coyote.
Coyote. That's simple as hell, right? Can I see? Let me see. Oh,
coyote,
you already closed. It's fine.
Coyote versus Roadrunner.
Yeah,
that's
dude.
The whole thing.
So, I mean, you can't have guns, but you can drop anvils and pianos and blow people up and do all this. Like, come on, you guys. You know what I mean? It's a part of the...
As it is.
It's just
as
it's,
it is.
It's because of the world that we live in. It's the sensitive world that we live in where they're afraid
I'm
that people are going to complain.
I'm just
this
over
cancel
it.
culture is going to go. They have guns with all the debate in the world now about guns. And it's like, just leave it out of the cartoons, though. It's not...
That's the same thing, dude.
That never-ending conversation. I'm sorry to cut you off. It's that never-ending conversation of, like, in cartoons and games and movies where they're like, well, my kids see this and then they want to replicate it. My kids are playing Grand Theft Auto and now they want to fuck hookers and steal cars. You know what I mean? It's like shit like that.
Here's my problem to you parents and Karens and Kevins of the world that are complaining about this and causing these issues. Your kids, they're rated a certain rating for a reason. If your kid is 1-year-old kid watching, you know, Coyote versus Roadrunner, watching shit they shouldn't be watching. That's your job as a parent
to correct that situation. Yeah, not to call them. The companies and go, you know what? No, this that's so your offensive. Job. Yeah, like, as a parent, yeah, dude, to get parent out of here. Your child and I to tell them what this, they can though. And can't watch.
I'll tell you this because like I dealt with this a lot. In particular, was when my mom she did not let us watch any of the night. Any of Nightmare on Elm Street. She did not let us watch any of the Freddy versus Jason, any of that until, I mean, obviously we snuck around. We snuck around and we watched it and did it.
Kids are kids.
Kids are kids, you know, but like her thing was like, not in front of me.
Yeah.
These parents and people, okay, not parents, this generation in general, it's like, hey, you have problems?
Here, just
go on and watch that cartoon while you eat.
Just fucking
go on and watch this while you do that.
Here, just put,
dude, I see little kids walking around with fucking iPhones. Yeah. iPhones, you know?
And then after they just go, here, just here to get to shut them up, then they go, wait a minute, what are you watching? Oh my God, I am calling WB right now. It's hold on, it's not WB's fault, it's your fault as a parent.
It's your fault as a parent, as what you're gonna make sure your kids input and taking in and learning.
We live in this world where everybody wants to complain and complain to the people instead of just taking certain things on themselves. Yeah. You know what I mean?
Have some fucking responsibility, come on, man.
Karen. All right, so we're gonna get into this week's cosplay of the week. This cosplay of the week doesn't really go with the theme of anything that we're talking about today, but it's just so amazing.
Yeah, phenomenal.
It's just so fucking amazing that I wanted to highlight it today, dude.
Yeah.
So I found this cosplay via horror_sketches, and I'm gonna throw up on the screen right about now. And this is from Pan's Labyrinth. If you guys ever remember that movie, it's a Guillermo del Toro movie. It's amazing.
Spanish flick, right?
Yeah. I think it's all in Spanish. All
subtitle shit.
Yeah. I think it's all in Spanish. You guys have to see this. Right now you're looking at it. It's from Pan's Labyrinth. And it's the, you know what? I don't know what the guy's name is for the listeners that aren't watching right now. Mm. But it's if you've seen Pan's Labyrinth, it's the dude at the dinner table with all the food and everything. And he uses his hands in the middle of his palms are his eyeballs. Eyes. And he uses his hands to see, you know? Yeah. So if you guys don't know what I'm talking about, that's what I'm talking about right now. And this is absolutely amazing. Once again, it was shared by horror_sketches. Mm-hmm. And the model, though, the person that's sitting there acting as this creature is Robin Screams on Instagram. And that is Robyn Screams on Instagram. And there's so many people involved with this. It's just so amazing.
The makeup artist
is Poison Beauty, and that's Poison_Beauty. The photographer is Sean P Photography. That is Sean_P_Photography. And it seems that horror_sketches, mm-hmm. actually they got this from another place, which is Horror Hags on Instagram.
Oh damn!
So a lot of people's stuff here, and we're definitely gonna have to go back and look at that. I'm gonna follow them right now.
Yeah.
Sorry guys, but So I mean, if you look at this, you guys, everybody involved in this, this is movie quality. I truly feel that Guillermo would actually look at this and be happy and be proud. You guys did this absolute justice.
This is one of those things you could tell was not half-assed. Everything from the makeup artist to the photographer to the model itself. Like, everything, dude. Like, they fucking nailed it, dude. And that shit looks fucking...
With the candles there on fire, illuminating a little bit. Yeah. I mean, it's absolutely amazing.
Well, yeah, because you see the focus is mainly up on the upper body, the face. Yes. Obviously, that's where a lot of the detail is.
Of course,
So, I mean, like, I like the way it's set up, like the little candles and stuff, but it's not the main part of it where it's, like, it's blinding.
It's right. It's just got that Gaussian effect. That,
you know what
it is?
It's the tone of that picture, dude.
And you can see it looks like there's a mirror or some sort or a frame of some sort in the background. It's even just like the little things that are not even in the forefront, the background stuff that just really brings it out. And I mean, this is an amazing cosplay, you guys. This is absolutely phenomenal.
I mean, like the armpits, dude.
Yeah, the skin on the neck area and everything, the flaps. The I mean, it's disgusting, and that's beautiful. Yeah. You know what I mean?
Horror wise, that's amazing, dude. You want out of a horror type of film or even movie, whatever you want to call it. You want that crazy detail.
It's
that's
amazing.
In there,
the hands, the elongated fingers and the fingernails. I wonder if the eyes are painted on there and look 3D, or I wonder if they were sticking out actually, you know, in real life, if they were sticking out. a little bit, or I wonder if it was a little bit more of just Photoshop thing. Mm-hmm. I wonder how that went. But either way, you guys, thank you, Horror Sketches, for sharing it. The makeup artist, Poison Beauty, you are on point with your makeup. The photographer just captured it beautifully. Yeah. You did a great job. Horror Hags also shared it, so that's amazing. Or maybe it came from Horror Hags. I'm not sure. Excuse me for my ignorance and not knowing exactly that. And the model, Robin Screams, you modeled this perfectly. All of you guys, absolutely phenomenal. Your cosplay for us of the week is amazing. So yeah, man. Good day today, man. Yeah. Good day today. A good episode.
Yeah, this I'm week, excited I to like be back, it. Dude.
Yeah, man. Yeah, we're glad to have you. Everybody seems glad to have you. Once again, let us know if you guys like this new setup. We're a little bit closer to the camera. We've got a little bit more things in the background. Let us know if you dig it. If you dig it, we're going to keep it. If you don't dig it, well, then fuck you. We're keeping it anyway. No, I'm just kidding. We may change it. Who knows? We're also going to see how we like it when it comes to editing and posts and everything. Stuff like that.
Yeah, because you got
to
consider the
pictures. We do certain things. We'll figure out how it all goes. But, man, thank you guys so much. Thank you for watching, for liking, for sharing, for commenting, for subscribing on YouTube, and if you're not, please, you guys, do it. Go down on the videos right there and hit that subscribe button. Hit the little bell too; it'll notify you on things. And once you do, you're gonna hit that. It's gonna go, ooh, subscribed. You're gonna hit the bell. It's gonna go, ding, and you're gonna like it. It's gonna go, oh shit! Guess what? You just received 100 project points. Thank you guys for listening on Apple, on Spotify, on Google, on all of those things that you listen on, and all that good shit. If you're looking for me, you can find me at IG Hates Chazzy on Instagram. And if you're looking for juice, where can they find you, man?
The reason you're here watching and listening to the Side Project Podcast is Captain_Juicebox. Pistols, Looney Tunes ain't taking them from me. Juicebox.
Hell yeah.
Gamertag Lord Juicebox 949.
Hit him up on Warzone. We're gonna
where all the pistols come out.
Hell yeah. If you're looking for us as a whole, you can find us at Side Project Podcast on Instagram. Hit the link in the bio to find us anywhere else you need to find us.
You know what I'm thinking? I'm going to have Tony take a picture of me holding up like my two, obviously not real pistols. I'm holding up my two little fake pistols. Mm-hmm. And then it's just going to be like, we all shoot. Kind of like
like the Borderlands picture where he's like that, dude. Hey, shoot, because he's got juice. Hey, thank you guys so much. We appreciate you all, each and every one of you, from the bottom of our hearts. Hit him with the pistols, man, because we're out.